It began as a typical high school girls lacrosse game between the Canterbury Cougars and the Palmetto Ridge Bears. For Canterbury, it was a matchup that soon proved challenging because of one problem.
It just kept going down, losing player after player.
Midfielder Melina Manulides and her teammates quickly became frustrated with the man they believed to be responsible, referee Artie Martinez.
I was the lead official of that game, and I caught Canterbury about five or six yellow cards. They were down to about four players.
But with the score tied and game headed to OT, the attention would change.
We went into overtime, and blew the whistle, started the game.
And then you see him running, and then he collapses, and we all just stopped.
All I remember was it went black, and I was just about to say to myself in the darkness of my mind, Artie, I think you're, and before I could say the word dead, I woke up.
Artie survived because someone at the game happened to know CPR. So many others there, including Melina, did not.
When I got home that night, I couldn't go to bed, so I talked with my parents, and I just told them how helpless I felt and how I couldn't do anything because I wasn't certified. I didn't know the techniques. We talked to Mr. Kirshner, our headmaster, and we set up a meeting, and I told him what the plan was. I told him what I wanted to do to transform our school.
Patients unresponsive.
Melina's goal became having every Canterbury student CPR certified. Teachers started training last year, and the rest of the school will soon follow.
The guy was definitely having trouble breathing.
After taking the course this past spring, school resource officer Tim DeVos already put his skills to use.
Right after he became an instructor, he saved someone's life on the street, pulled over and saved him.
Similar circumstances will certainly follow, with more lives certainly saved, all because of a 16-year-old who saw it once.
I'll be talking this story forever. It's part of my life now.
And made it her mission to never be helpless again. In Fort Myers, Sean Martinelli, NBC2.